Hello and welcome back to my FE8 negative voice. For today I'll be showing you chapter 18. Chapter 18 is a very unique chapter. It's a world chapter, but there are only 10 real enemies at the start of the map. And the rest of the enemies are 24 eggs. These eggs hatch into gorgons after a while, and these gorgons are very threatening. That's why I want to kill them while they're still in the egg form, because they don't attack, they don't counter, they don't move. They have really terrible stats of just HP and 10 defense and resistance. So killing them is not really that difficult. And unless you are some of my units, like, I don't know, F-Frame with a javelin, because he just deals 2x2 damage. So that's why he needs to get the spear here. Or someone like Vanessa or Tana, who deals 0 damage with Sim Lances, and then I think like 2 damage with the Iron Lance. Some of my units have become so bad at this point that they can't even kill the Axe. But most of my units really can deal with these pretty easily. Even the Phantom can easily one round most Axe. And during this chapter I undeployed Vanessa and Tana for the reason that I already said. They are pretty pathetic when it comes to stats, and their movement is really not all that useful in this chapter. That's why I didn't bring them. La Rochelle, because she can't fight, and I also undeployed Dozer, because getting him anywhere is really awkward, because he has 16 constitution and none of my units can rescue him. So if I want to get him somewhere with another unit, he would have to be the one rescuing, and he doesn't have Kanto, which makes it kind of awkward. And that's why I just didn't bring him. I instead brought Myr, and another advantage of Myr in comparison to Dozer is that she always wanted KOs any enemies during this chapter, while Dozer just wanted KOs with a crit. So using her is a lot more reliable. During this first turn I have to barrier up Comic, because otherwise he would get one shot by one of the Gorgons that start on the map, and I also have him kill a Gargoyle, so that Gargoyle can't kill the Phantom that I put as close to the Gorgon as possible. I killed him with a Pierce Crit, because then the Phantom ends up dying, and I wanted to have the flexibility of getting the extra movement boost for the Phantom from being summoned in a different position. But I didn't end up using this. Moda warps Seth together with Myr over this uncrossable terrain, so that they can get to the bottom right of the part of the map as soon as possible, because there are a few enemies that they have to deal with. Meanwhile, the units from the back try to clean up the way for my other units. And I also have Ephraim carry Garrick since the last turn, and now I will have them go towards the top part of the map by having Sally use the Wesker Staff that we got for keeping all of the green units alive in the last chapter, and that makes it a lot faster to get them to the top of the map. Using the Wesker Staff here is better than using the Warp Staff, because the Warp Staff can't quite get over this platform on the left, so I would have to go around that platform, and that would just lose them a bit of movement. So using the Rescue Staff is a lot better. I don't actually end up killing this Gorgon this turn, because the Gorgon wants to attack the Phantom again. Because while she would be able to kill Cormac, because he gets hit by one other enemy, and I think maybe she can kill Ephraim. But she wants to go for the Phantom, because I think the reason why she wants to go for the Phantom is because she can one-hit KO him and go to her maximum attack range. But I'm not 100% sure. But it happens, so might as well make use of it. Seth goes down to 4 HP here. He needs to do some very dangerous things during this remainder of the turn. I could heal him after that, but I kind of forgot that. So I left him at 4 HP for the rest of the chapter. And he only has to fight one more enemies after the ones that are in this position. But even then, having him healed up would make it a lot easier, because he wouldn't have to dodge the 50% hit chance. Sally once again uses the rescue to get Dissu to the upper part of the map, because he can use the Garm. He can basically one-shot anything, and yeah, having him up here is really nice to help with killing off the enemies that will be here at some point. During this following enemy phase, Garrick has a slight chance of death. He dies to... if he gets hit by one of the spiders, he gets killed by the gargoyle. If he dodges both the spiders, then he is perfectly safe. And if he dodges only one of the spiders, he does... he can also get hit by the eyeball, otherwise he would have to dodge the other spider and the... and the other... and the gargoyle. Now I have Sally's science, one of the Gorgons, because I don't want her to attack me during the enemy phase, because she has the very dangerous stone spell, which basically takes one of my units out of the chapter, because I don't really have the time to use the rescue staff, restore staff, not rescue. I warp Tephis to the right. This was maybe a mistake in retrospective, because this meant I had to do some very awkward strats in one of the later chapters, but it just barely works out, so maybe it wasn't that bad. Garrick quits a bunch with the killer axe, which makes it very nice, and he easily kills all of these melee units. I don't have an axe that could have broken during the enemy phase, so sadly he can't counter the eyeball. Maybe if I had done some better preparations in one of the earlier chapters, this could have been changed, but it's not all that important, because that alone wouldn't have saved me a turn here. Cormac needs to attack this egg from one range, because if he steps onto one of those lava tiles, he dies, because he's only at 10 HP, and those deal exactly 10 damage. Serene is about to show us just how good she is, and she doesn't one round this Gorgon, because she doesn't have enough speed to double as a Pegasus Knight, as a Falcon Knight even. Now I have Sally hammer the rescue staff, because it's a really useful staff. I could have used the safest hammer used for the warp staff, which would have made the later chapters a bit easier, because I think the warp is a bit better than the rescue. But doing this way is better for Sally's staff rank, because there is this tiny glitch that this patch has, which causes the last use of any staff not to give staff XP. So normally if I had Sally use all of the staff uses of the hammer, he would gain 24 staff XP, which already puts him pretty much at halfway to B rank, and about fourth or a fifth to A rank, so using that with him a lot is really nice. But sadly here it only grants him 16 staff XP, which is of course not as much, and he doesn't need to use it. I can't really get around using it with Sally, so I have to do something to get him more staff XP than the otherwise would. Especially since I not only break the Hammond staff with Sally, I also break the Wesker staff with Sally in my original one, and I also broke the Silent staff with him, which would mean that he wastes 3 turns with not getting staff XP, and 20 staff XP, in theory, in comparison to a non-glitched worm. And that's of course really bad, because it makes it a lot harder to get to A-Ring staff, especially since those 20 staff XP are from pretty much the highest staff XP stays that I have. And there is not really a good way to make up for that, because making that up with the barrier staff would take 5 turns. And I don't really have the time. That's why I ended up hammering the rescue staff instead of the warp staff once more, because he can use the rescue staff, and the warp staff he can't. And doing that of course makes it a bit easier to get to A-Ring staff, because the rescue staff does grant an additional 3 points of staff XP compared to the barrier staff, and using it 2 additional times is 6 extra staff XP, and that's of course really great. Erika sadly needs to get a crit to kill this gargoyle in one hit. During this turn I also spent another use of the science staff onto this eyeball, because if I hadn't silenced the eye, I would have had to kill it with Sally or with someone else, because otherwise it would kill Tephys in combination with the lava tile, and I really don't want to do that. Or rather, I really don't want it to happen, and I could still RNG manipulate, but the hit rate of the eyeball is pretty high, and Garrick also has a chance of death. Also, you might have seen me miss the second opportunity to use the elixir with Seth. He did end up blocking one of the reinforcements this turn, because basically all of the reinforcements on this turn are area-based. So as soon as I had one of my units enter that area with the 3 remaining eggs and on the right, the 2 spiders spawned there. But since Seth took up one of those spaces, only one spider spawned, and that makes it of course easier to kill. Having him use an elixir would mean that I wouldn't have to make sure that he dodges the spider. Then he would only need a hit and a crit. Now I just need to make sure that all of the remaining enemies die, and I also use some more staff uses on Sally. He used the Hammer and stuff once this chapter, he used the Science stuff twice, the Rescue stuff 3 times, and 4 times the Barrier stuff. This, together with the, I think, 48 staff XP from the last chapter, puts him at 101 staff XP, so he will reach A-Ring staves at some point during the next 2 chapters for sure. And this was chapter 18 in 6 turns. Thank you for watching, and bye.